Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about history lesson 12, the nationalist movement from 1885 to 1919. This period otherwise known as pre-Gandhian era. In this lesson we will discuss about impact of Western education, unification of the country, economic exploitation by the British, discrimination law against the Indians, partition of Bengal, the Government of India Act, growth of press and literature, the birth of Indian National Congress, moderates and radicals, formation of Muslim League, Surat split, and also the rise of revolutionaries. Students, we have already studied Great Revolt of 1857. Okay, it was suppressed by the British. So, our Indian people had a resentment against the colonial rule. So, they uprising in different part of our country. So, gradually in the following decades, a collective desire for freedom from the British rule began to develop among the Indians. This has led to the growth of nationalism. Lot of factors led to the growth of nationalism. Here, first we will discuss about impact of Western education. The introduction of English education in India exposed the Indian to Western ideas of like liberty, democracy and nationalism. Indian people become aware of the nationalist movement in Europe and also the America. The French Revolution and also the American War of Independence inspired them to wage similar struggles against the foreign domination in India. Next, we will discuss about growth of press and literature. The rise of English and vernacular newspaper in India enabled the spread of nationalist idea among the Indians. Writers like Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, Rabindranath Tagore and Bal Gangadhar Tilak inspired the people with their patriotic writing and they encouraged them to unite against the British. Unification of the country. The British introduced rail and road network and the postal service and also the telegraph system to ensure efficient administration of the India for their own benefit. Economic exploitation by the British. The establishment of colonial rule in India was accompanied by the economic exploitation of the country's rich resources. The systematic transfer of wealth from India to England through various ways. This was explained by our great leader Dadabhai Nauroji as the drain of wealth. As a result of the economic exploitation by the British, India's traditional industries were destroyed. Most of the workers were lost their jobs. At the same time, several famine in the second half of the 19th century led to peasants become a poorer. Discrimination laws against Indians. Indian Arm Act, it was introduced in 1878. It forbade Indian from processing weapons. At the same time, no restrictions were imposed on the British. The Vernacular Press Act, it also implemented the same period of 1878. but it prohibited the vernacular newspaper from publishing anti-British essays. The Gilbert Bill. This is also one of the discrimination law against the Indians. It introduced 1883. It stated that British or a European in India could be tried by an Indian judge. The Europeans and Anglo-Indians in India forcefully opposed the bill on the ground that an Indian judge, in spite of his her experience and seniority, was incapable of trying a European. As a result, the government of British finally amended the bill. The educated Indians felt humiliating at the action of the British government. As a result of growing up sense of nationalism among the Indians, several associations were formed in various parts of our country. But most of these were limited in their scopes. Then in 1885, the Indian National Congress was formed. This is marking the launch of next stage of nationalist movement in India. Birth of Indian National Congress. The Indian National Congress was founded in 1885 on the advice of Allan Actervyn Hume. He was a retired British civil servant. The first session of the Indian National Congress held at Bombay. Indian National Congress promote the growth of political consciousness among the people of India. W.C. Banerjee was the first president of the Congress. The other important, most important leaders included Dadabhai Nauroji, Feroz Shah Mehta, Tinsukia Wacha, so on. Next, we will discuss about moderates and radicals. Moderates voiced their demand through peaceful method like petition, appeals. So they came to know be as the moderates. Some important moderates were Surendranath Banerjee, Gopalakrishna Gokhale, Feroz Shah Mehta. Next, we will discuss about radicals. They began demanding Swaraj or complete independence from British rule. These leaders came to be known as the radicals. Bal Gangadhar Tilak in Maharashtra, Bipin Chandra Pal in Bengal, and Lala Lajpat Rai in Punjab. Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He said, "Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it." Students, look at this picture. These leaders came to be known as moderates. Students, we have already studied Great Revolt of 1857. Okay, it was suppressed by the British. So our Indian people had a resentment against the colonial. Next, we will discuss about the partition of Bengal. Since 1765, the Bengal had been a single united provinces, including West Bengal, East Bengal, Bihar, and also the Odisha. It emerged as a center of the nationalism in the 19th century. At the time, the Viceroy of India was Lord Curzon. Lord Curzon decided to partition Bengal in 1905 and separate the Muslim-dominated East Bengal from West Bengal. But he said the partition of Bengal was only for the administration purpose. But our Indians think that even the Muslims and also the Hindus think that this is one of the divide and rule policy. So they strongly oppose it. Next, we will discuss about the boycott and Swadeshi movement. Indian nationalists reacted to the partition of Bengal by launching the boycott and Swadeshi movements. One side, they boycotted or refused to use the goods made by the British. On other side, they began to actively develop the manufacture of Swadeshi or product made in India by Indians. As the result of boycott and Swadeshi movement, Swadeshi textile mill, soap and match factories, bank and insurance companies came up everywhere. It also leading in turn to a revival, which means again into use of local Indian industries also. National schools and colleges were also founded in various parts of India, many of which began given training in Swadeshi craft. The British reacted to the movement by arresting thousands of Swadeshi workers, including students. Next, we will discuss about the formation of Muslim League. The growing presence of Indian National Congress, some Indian Muslims began to feel that it was a Hindu majority organization which did not sufficiently represent their interest. So they felt the need for separate platform that would exclusively cater to their needs. So some of the Muslim leaders met at Simla to discuss the possibilities of forming such an organization. At a conference in Dhaka in 1906, the All India Muslim League was founded under the leadership of Aga Khan, Nawab Salimullah of Dhaka and Nawab Mozinul Malk. Next, we will discuss about the Surat split. The Indian National Congress Party divided into two groups at the place of Surat session in the time of 1907. Because they have a different ideological. So they divided into two groups, namely moderate and radicals. I think already we have studied about the both groups. Isn't it? Next, we will discuss about the Marley-Minto reform. Lord Minto succeeded Hassan as the Viceroy of India. He introduced a lot of reform to the Indians. Along with John Marley, he was the Secretary of State in England. Lord Minto passed the Indian Council Act of 1909. It was also popularly known as Marley-Minto reform. The Act stated that the number of elected members of Central and Provincial Legislative Council increased. At the same time, the Act also introduced a separate electorate for Muslims. Next, we will discuss about the Government of India Act. Every certain period, the British passed the Government of India Act. This was one of the Government of India Act passed by the British in the time of 1919. Sustained pressure from the Indian leaders led to the British government passing the Government of India Act 1919. The Act increased the number of elected members to the Provisional Council and introduced the dual system of government. Under the Government of India Act in 1919, certain departments like finance, law, order and police under the control of British government. At the same time, education, agriculture, health under the responsibility of the Indian ministries. Okay, thank you, students.